know about Donald Trump wanting to build his own border.
My administration has done more than any administration in history to secure our southern border. Our border has never been more secure.
These nuts. Got it!
However, there is also a long list of borders that, interestingly enough, are being disputed over. These borders are reason enough to show how much different parts of the world don't even trust other countries. We think it's best that everybody knows the reason behind these borders. Welcome to The Bestest, the channel that provides you the bestest news and videos you should know about. In today's episode, we'll discuss the oddest borders in the world, and that you should know about. Before we start, please make sure to like and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to get notifications of our videos. We all know that The Bestest can serve you a platter filled with everything you have yet to find out. Over the course of time, more and more borders exist. Countries all over the world continue to fight over various territories and, ironically, even borders. The world we live in has seen wars and many tragedies that start with border disputes. This ultimately became a whole other disaster. However, we do learn that life moves forward. In this episode, The Bestest will highlight some of the oddest borders that exist in the world. And we should all know the stories behind these borders. At number one, we have the Bir Tawil. It is a piece of land that's about 2,060 square kilometers in size. This is the border that lies between Egypt and Sudan. Bir Tawil was inadvertently created in 1902 when United Kingdom drew a different border from one created in 1899. These borders, Bir Tawil and Halaib, were created in different areas. It's officially from Sudan since Egypt has already claimed Halaib. However, it was constantly being disputed over by both countries. Each country insists that Bir Tawil belongs to the other. This makes Bir Tawil the only piece of land in the world outside of Antarctica that is not claimed by any nation. Now that's interesting. It's probably one of the world's unfinished disputes. Stay until the end of this episode to learn more about the different borders we have around the world. Let's move on to the next one. At number two, we have the Diomedes. They are a pair of islands in Bering Strait. It hosts the American city of Diomede with a population of 146. Big Diomede belongs to Russia and is uninhabited, while Little Diomede hosts the American city of Diomede. These two are only about 4 kilometers apart. The international dateline passes between the Diomedes and serves also as the border between the United States and Russia. At number 3, we have Mount Everest. It is known as the tallest mountain in the world. It's more than just that. It is known to be the border between Nepal and China that goes right through the middle of the mountain. This includes the peak itself, so this isn't just the highest mountain, but it is also the highest border area. At number 4, we have the territorial claims on Antarctica. These are considered as borders since we've mentioned that this is one area that's unclaimed. There are 7 countries that claim pie-shaped wedges of Antarctica. No nation can even modify or act upon its territorial claim. Strait boundaries typically lead from 60 degrees south to the South Pole, divide up to the continent, and overlap in some instances. However, there are also significant segments that remain unclaimed. Some even continue to compete claims over the boundaries of Antarctica. At number 5, we have the Spain-Morocco border. This border is called Ceuta. It is an 18.5 square kilometer autonomous city in Spain. This is an exclave located on the north coast of North Africa while being surrounded by Morocco. But that's not all, since it is separated from the Iberian Peninsula by the Strait of Gibraltar. Ceuta lies on the border of the Mediterranean Sea and the Atlantic Ocean. Morocco claims that this border, along with the Spanish autonomous city of Melilla, and a number of Mediterranean islands which border it. This has led Spain to erect a 3-meter high border fence around the city topped with barbed wire. Borders exist for the sake of avoiding even greater conflicts. However, a lot of issues come up when countries start to fight over it. You will never know what happens next. Make sure to stay with us until the end of this episode to know what are the oddest borders in the whole world. At number 6, we have the Derby Line in Vermont. It is the town that straddles the border of the United States and Canada. This passes right through the town, even through some buildings and homes. Derby Line is also home to the Haskell Free Library, an opera house that was purposely built on the border. These buildings have 2 mailing addresses since it straddles on the border. It's one for the United States and another one for Canada. We can hear Hannah Montana saying they have the best of both worlds. At number 7, we have the Barle-Nassau and Barle-Hertog. Barle-Nassau is a municipality in the Netherlands, while the Barle-Hertog is a Belgian municipality. It consists of 26 separate pieces of land and is surrounded by Barle-Nassau. Some portions of the Barle-Hertog also contain areas belonging to Barle-Nassau. The smallest part belonging to Belgium is only a quarter of the hectare. The border is complicated since there are even some houses bisected by it. At number 8, we have the District of Columbia. It was originally a big diamond carved out of Maryland and Virginia. The size, shape, and location makes the border have some unusual features. Large stones were placed 1 mile apart around the entire District of Columbia when it was originally delineated to further define the border. Since the original district was 10 miles long on each side, 100 stones are there all in all. Although there are a few stones missing today, the border continues to stand. At number 9, we have Namibia's Caprivi Strip. Northeastern Namibia has a panhandle that extends far east several hundred miles. This is what separates Botswana from Zambia. The Caprivi Strip provides Namibia access to Zambezi River, located near the Victoria Falls. Its name is for German Chancellor Leo von Caprivi. He was the one who made the panhandle part to provide Germany access to Africa's eastern coast. There's also so much politics surrounding these areas. Some even had intense situations, which are sure to become worse if not prevented. And now we're almost at the end of this episode. The last one is bound to both shock and interest you. However, there are still others that we chose not to highlight in this episode, but we're sure you'd find the last one interesting too. Now, moving on to the last border on our episode. At number 10, we have the Korean Demilitarized Zone. It is a strip of land about 258 kilometers long and 4 kilometers wide. That's the one we see dividing North and South Korea. The Korean Demilitarized Zone is considered as the most heavily militarized border in the world. It is so heavily guarded and almost nobody ever enters it. This border inadvertently created a nature preserve which a number of highly endangered species have taken residence to. Some of these species are even somehow increasing in population. Although it does not delineate a border, it surrounds a military demarcation line which was both agreed upon North and South Korea despite still being at war.
Oh my god! Wow! Oh my god!
We truly have faced a lot of things over the course of time. These borders are a part of a way to try to avoid conflict all over the world. And that is what makes these borders even more interesting. Managing these borders are even harder due to a lot of current economic problems. However, we do hope that further conflicts do not escalate. So what is the border that interested you the most? Let us know in the comments section below. Make sure to like and subscribe to The Bestest and hit the bell to access more of our videos. Thank you so much for watching, and until our next Bestest video.